Good morning, Manala. This is Manos. Today, I would like to discuss about the basic electrical engineering concepts. So what are the concepts which comes under the basic electrical engineering means? So itself, we would like to know about some basics in the electrical engineering. So that is, what is meant by voltage, what is meant by current, electric current, what is meant by power, what is meant by resistor, inductor, capacitor, if the resistors are connected in series, if the resistors are connected in parallel. So what is the equations, and more about the basic electrical engineering concepts, the most important concepts is what is meant by Ohm's law, what is the limitations of Ohm's law, and what are the applications of Ohm's law, and the Kirchhoff's laws. So these all are the some basics which all comes under the DC circuits. So I said already, so starting on is so electrical potential. So what is mean by this electrical potential is, so people sometimes also call as the potential difference, and it is denoted with V. So electric potential V is work done per charge. So it is denoted with V, and the ratio between the work done per charge means how much work is needed to be done to move the charge from one point to infinite is called as electric potential. So we will write the equation V is equal to work done is W by Q. So, and what is the units for the electric potential? Work done is joules, per charge is coulombs. So denoted with V, and this is for the equation, and the units is joules per coulomb, and one more unit is called as volts. And I said already, this is also called as potential difference. The potential difference between the two points is also called as, people will say that voltage, that is also called as electrical potential. So moving on to the next one is electric current. So electric current is denoted with I, capital letter or small letter, can is your choice, and the units is amperes. Yes, and what is meant by this electric current means, normally in general, where how we can define this electric current means, flow of electrons from the higher potential to lower potential, or flow of charges from the higher potential to lower potential is called as electric current, denoted with capital I or the small I, and the unit is amperes, because the amperes is the scientist name who given the notice. A definition for the electric current, our people sometimes write it as I is equals to Q by T. Or if you write in the differential form, you can write rate of change of charge with respect to time, dQ by dt, is also called as electric current. So dQ, rate of change of charge, dt with respect to time, is called as electric current. I, and the units is coulomb per second,
coulomb per second, because the charge is coulombs and the time should be in seconds. Coulomb per second, or one more unit is called as amperes.
This is what we call as electric potential, and this is called as electric current, and these are the notations. Moving on to the next one is electric power.
Denoted with P, and the units is watts. So what is meant by this electric power means?
People will say that in general
way of defining this electric power means the multiplication of voltage and current is called as electric power.
So that is P is equals to V into I,
and the units are watts. So this is what I can say in general manner.
So moving on to the next one is
resistance. So it is denoted with R, and it is a passive two terminal device, and the resistance is the property of a resistor, that is element. So what is, how we can define a resistance means? Resistance which does not, or resistor which does not allow the flow of electrons, or which restricts the flow of electrons, is called as resistance, denoted with R, and the units is, you can denote it with the symbol is ohms, and R you can write it as ohms. People in general they will write resistance R is equals to V by I. According to the Ohm's law, this is according to the Ohm's law, they will write R, else resistance is directly proportional to L by A. So resistance is directly proportional to length of the conductor, and inversely proportional to area of cross section.
Two elements are proportional to R is equals to
the proportionality constant rho into L by A, where rho is called as resistivity, and right here is, whereas R is resistance in ohms, resistance in ohms. Rho is called as proportionality constant, called as resistivity. And L is called as length of the conductor. And A is called as area of cross section. I'm just simply writing
area.
So this is,
we have the two formulas according to the Ohm's law, R is equals to V by A, and according to the general equation, R is equals to L by A. That means that is length of the conductor, A is area of cross section, inversely proportional to area of cross section, and directly proportional to length of the conductor, and rho is called as resistivity,
and which does not allow the flow of electrons, or which restricts the flow of electrons, is called as resistance.
And next one I am just writing inductance.
Denoted with L, and the inductor unit is henries.
Ohm is a scientist name, and again Henry is also a scientist name. So this inductance is also called as, or the inductor is also called as choke, is also called as coil, or is also called as reactor. And yes, previously I forgot to tell you, so the symbol for the resistor is this one, and whereas for the symbol for the inductor is this one.
The number of turns, it is also a passive two terminal element, and the number of turns either of ferromagnetic core or electromagnetic core, and You can denote it with this symbol, use a for, or else you denote it with two lines. This is iron core, or if you denote it with double dash lines, this is a ferromagnetic core inductor symbol. So these are the different types of symbol, but in general manner will denote it with this. Yes, moving on to next one is, so L is equals to, so it does not allow the flow of properties. Inductor has a property which stores energy in the form of magnetic field, and the equation and the inductor property, the main inductor property is, it does not allow the flow of current, which does not allow the sudden changes in current. So where the di by dt is rate of change of current with respect to time, which does not allow this inductor. So whereas the voltage is across, and write the voltage across inductor is V is equals to L into di by dt. So whereas L is equals to V into V by dt by di. You can write. So these are the equations for the inductor. So moving on to the next one is the capacitor. So capacitor is capacitance. Capacitor, resistor, inductor, all these are called as elements. Resistance, inductance, capacitance are the properties of the elements called as R, L, C. Denoted with C, and the units means farad. Again, the farad means the scientist name. And yes, the symbol for the capacitor is this one. So it is nothing but two conducting plates, two parallel conducting plates separated by a thin insulating medium, are also called as a dielectric medium. It is called as a capacitor. So it is consists of, again, it is a two terminal passive element. So where the, these two are the conducting plates. Separated by a thin insulating medium are also called as dielectric, is called as a capacitor, and the capacitance is the property of a capacitor. And the equation for the capacitor is C is equals to Q by V, whereas Q is proportional to V. The rate of change of charge is directly proportional to the applied voltage or the input voltage. So in fact, the proportional to Q is equals to C into V. So where C is a proportionality constant, the constant is nothing but your capacitance. Q is equals to C into V. So where C is equals to Q by V. So units is coulomb, spark, volt, RS, I said farads. And one more next one is, so this is what we call it as capacitance, inductance. And the most important concept is, as you already know that, Ohm's law. So in the year 1872, a scientist called as George Simon Ohm, gave a relation between the three parameters across voltage, current, and resistance. According to that, I is proportional to V. I can say that V is proportional to I, or it is not correct. So the electric current, the flow of electrons, is directly proportional to the potential difference between the two points, whereas I is proportional to V. So V is equals to, you can write I R. So we have the proportionality, whereas R is called as constant. At constant temperature and pressure, the flow of electrons is directly proportional to the potential difference between the two conductors or two points, where R should be always constant at constant temperature and pressure. So I is equals to, can write V by R. And one more equation we have, R is equals to V by I. So these are the three formulas we are having.
So this is called as Ohm's law.